Let us consider another example. So here the example we have taken with the fractional part. So subtract 1001.101 base 2 from 1011.01 base 2. That means the subtraction operation we have to perform using 1's complement. So first write down our A. That means 1001.101 from this number. I have to subtract this number, so that's why my A becomes this one. So 1011.01. So my B is 1001.101. So now, so before proceeding to step number 1, we have to make equal number of digits. So look at here, the problem is with fractional part here, the whole number, and this is a fractional part. First make fractional part, so equal number. See, look at here, don't count, so whole number plus fractional. Here 2 plus 5 is 7, again 4 plus 3 is 7, so these are not in equal number of digits. We have to make equal number of fractional digits, equal number of whole digits. So that means here 3 are there, so one more 0 I will place here without affecting its value. So these digits becomes equal, that means fractional digits will become equal. So now here 4 are there, here 5, so one more 0 I will place here, so the value will not be altered. So now I can apply the rules. So going for step number 1, so step number 1, so it is using 1's complement method. So obtain 1's complement of B. So that means 1's complement of B, 1's complement of B. So that is 1011.010. So that means we have changed zeros to ones, ones to zeros. So step number 2 is add A and 1's complement of B. So A is this one. So 1011.010. So now this has been added, 1's complement of B, so that is nothing but 1011.010. So this has been added to A. So after addition, what will get? So 0, 1 plus 1 is 1011 So again 1, so 1 plus 1 is 10. So the carry has been generated. So if carry has been generated, so the result is positive, and add carry to the LSB, least significant bit. Here, look at here, this has to be added to this fractional part. So don't add to the whole number part. So that is our answer. After adding this, what will get here? 0101.101. That means 0 plus is 1, so remaining terms as it is. So you can verify, so using calculator, please all of you. So because we have to convert first this 1001.101, so that is equivalent to 9.625. So and 1011.01, which is equivalent to 23.25. That means 23.25 minus 9.625. So I am getting answer as a 13.625. So 13.625. So how to verify this answer means we don't have other ways. We have to convert all these digits into, that means A, B, and the answer that has been converted into decimal number system. So then we can verify. So hence the answer is 13.625. If I convert this 1101.101, so already you know 1101 means 13, 101 means again you are getting 625. So hence the answer.